HIMT, Hindustan Institute of Maritime Training.
Today we shall discuss about this float system. I am going to appoint you to your MEP courses. I am going to talk in general. You may classify it separately. Requirement. Float system is put through the flame by smothering. Smothering means displacing oxygen. Because the density of the COD is 1.5 times more than the atmospheric air, so it settles down. Whenever I am applying that CO2, the oxygen is depleted or displaced. Thereby the flame goes off. I use the word flame, kindly remember this. Even though the flame is off, fire can still exist. In case I am not cooling it, it may reignite. One major drawback is there in CO2 and dry chemical powder. So boundary cooling has to continue till my temperature comes below flash. How do I check up the temperature to the bottom platform? We have got the thermal imaging, laser guns, etc. To an extent of area what it can cover, I can find out the temperature. So re-entry kindly avoid immediately. Re-entry can be done once the temperature is below flash point. Till such time we continue the boundary cooling. COT expands. So entry, if you do that, the major disadvantage of CO2 is it creates asphyxiation. Human cannot breathe. That's the main drawback. So accordingly, the presently the system is for the enclosed areas like the machinery space, pump room, purifier room, etc. We use CO2 as a generalized agent, total fitting, to put out the flame, because these are all where the vapors are really pronounced. So we have basically four estimation systems. The fourth one is the CO2 system. So that we will see what are the requirements, because safety considerations are really high, and the amount of CO2 required depending upon your volume of the machinery space or pump room. Even for cargo holds in bulk carriers, you can have a CO2 system. The volume calculation is separate. How you are going to calculate, what is the minimum requirement, etc. You can find out one by one. So it is actually a fixed perforating system. It actually puts out the fire or flame by mainly by smothering action. So normally used in the protected space such as engine room, cargo hold, purifier room, pump room, etc. and tankers. Some ships they have this high expansion pump, but general preference is CO2. One extra addition I want to make here is what I understand is in future perhaps they may deploy high fog systems and take away the CO2 system. Not yet promulgated. It may turn out the future, mainly because the present day understanding is fire is due to rise in temperature above flash point. If I can control the temperature below flash point, fire cannot take place, so no flame can take place. That's the idea. High fog system is providing extensive cooling to bring down the temperature very fast. So the CO2 system contains CO2 cylinders, number depending upon the total quantum required, the volume calculation, etc. There are two types of CO2 system. Some of you might have seen that. One is called a high pressure system, another is called low pressure system. In low pressure system, we got a big cylinder wherein we store that required quantum of liquid CO2, and then that container is refrigerated. With the refrigeration, we maintain the temperature. But whereas high pressure system, we got a number of cylinders arranged in the manifold, and we have a sequence of releasing the cylinders.
They say 85% of the total volume has to be released within 2 months.
How the evacuation, how the arrangement, different things given. Mainly you have to refer to the FSS code, what is the requirement of the specifications, etc. How it is needed to store. What are the test requirements regarding this? That is given in FTP code, fire test procedures code. That we will see subsequently. So the CO2 system, even though you got portable and the fixed one, portable is only for the small fires, fixed one for the large splitting on the fire or flame. So CO2 system, from the cylinder it releases to a manifold. From the manifold goes to the machinery space, whatever, wherever you want to send. The outlet in the pipeline is, you got a nozzle. We got a nozzle. So what is the thing, you have to be very, very careful. Generalized precision, I am saying. Everything is done automatically, okay. The valve is opened first by means of a 5x cylinder, and then the time delay unit, then your subsequent cylinders are activated, etc. Pressure rises first. Where? In the manifold. Because CO2 from the cylinder, it goes to a small pipeline, goes to a larger diameter. Principle of diffuser. Principle of diffuser. And then high pressure CO2 goes into the engine room and again comes through a nozzle where the pressure is dropped but velocity is increased. So liquid becomes vapor. Yeah, gas. I am not sending a liquid into the machinery space, I am sending only gas. This concept you must understand thoroughly. So the nozzles can get eroded. Nozzles can get, because velocity is increasing. Velocity is increasing. So number of nozzles, the distance between nozzles depending upon your machinery space requirement, where it is critical, etc. That is to be done. So for the safety reasons, the CO2 flooding system, we have it as a manual control instead of having auto control, especially in the machinery space, etc. Once the alarm comes, the people have to evacuate. They have to come out. Normally preferable to whatever procedure you have. General procedure, what I know of is, come to the emergency escape, report to master station by your rank and name. After that, the chief engineer, after taking the tally, then he informs master and then releases the CO2. Some of the ships nowadays, we have got in 2-3 places, you have got the CO2 releasing system. If you are unable to come to a particular station, fire control station, it can be operated remotely. Now one system is there, what I understand is in the CO2 room itself. Another one is in the fire control station, that is a normal arrangement. The main advantage of CO2 is, it has got a high rate of expansion, which allows it to work fast or spread very fast. So the CO2 provides a heavy blanket of gas that reduces the oxygen level. You know what percentage? 11%. Flame requires minimum 11% of oxygen by volume. Anything got below 11%, the flame cannot exist, but fire can exist. Fire can exist. That is a new understanding about the fire. Please understand this. The existing concept is that fire triangle, three elements. But the new understanding is that fire triangle is a flame triangle, because fire and flame, they are being identified in a different way. Major advantage is carbon dioxide is a gas, liquid has become gas, so clean up operation is very simple. So before making entry, I must ensure that enough oxygen is there, exhaust fan has to run, etc. You have to wait. It will be sitting down at the bottom because density is very high. Density is very high. So the advantage is given here. Density is about 1.5 times higher. It can be easily liquefied in the bottle. Reason for the dip tube. Reason for the CO2 cylinder has got a dip tube. Well, outlet I want to be a liquid, not as a vapor or anything. Suddenly expand within the cylinder, it will become dry. So remember about the critical temperature of CO2. How much it is? 1.5. Am I right? 31.52. So what all you find, you can refer to Google and find out that the exact critical temperature. We are supposed to maintain the temperature of CO2 room within that, otherwise that CO2 will start vaporizing. CO2 will start vaporizing. Depending upon the pressure and temperature, PV is equal to NRT. Kindly don't forget that. If your temperature is going up, pressure will build up. Pressure will. For example, at 30 degrees, just an example I am giving, that pressure is say 56 bar into the CO2 cylinder. When the temperature goes to 40, it may go up to 72, 73 bar. So possibility in summer regions or where the temperature is going to go up, the pressure may build up in the CO2 bottle. So we must have safety devices. Cylinder head itself has got a brushing disc. Set for approximately 180 bar, but the value differs. Different people have got different concepts. They say it varies from 175 to 190 bar, but generally it's around 180 bar normally set. So when the temperature increases, pressure corresponding when it crosses 180, it releases, that CO2 will go into the CO2 zone itself. That bursting disc which is going to open from the cylinder head, it goes into the CO2 room itself. So before entering, you must be very careful. Start the exhaust fan. Start the exhaust. Wait for some time. Then keep the main door open. Even when you are going for inspection, this is required. By chance, there was a CO2 leakage or something, this is not affected. It's not affected. And the CO2 is non-corrosive, but nozzles will have erosion because velocity is increasing. Velocity is increasing. And CO2 is not meant to electricity. Some of the ships still we have the CO2 portable extinguishers for switchboard fire. But it is changing. Already they have started using this NOVEC 1230. NOVEC, NOVEC. Second point is very important. CO2 has got a very little cooling effect. When it expands, it may become dry ice. But when it is injected to high velocity, it has got no cooling effect. So reignition is always possible. After extinguishing the flame, underline flame, continue the boundary cooling till the temperature comes down to avoid reignition or a fire technique. So possibility when the velocity is increasing. We know static electricity is nothing but friction between the two surfaces. So this will create static charges. Better protect yourself before entering. Static charges will start dissipating the charges towards the ground or equal point. This is the CO2 system what they have given. Certain differences are there between the different countries using. Certain things may not be mentioned here in the drawing, but you have to include. We have got two sets of pilot cylinders, okay. Each cabinet has got at least two cylinders are there. When the CO2 is coming, it has to come through a non-return valve to activate. Whether it is a master valve activation or the manifold activation. Wherever the pilot cylinder is releasing CO2, on the outlet we should have one non-return valve. Kindly, even though it is not mentioned here, please remember you have to include it. It is a mandatory requirement, non-return valve, so that the bulk missing cannot go back to the pilot cylinder. There is a bank of main cylinders, the capacity, this is different, pilot cylinder capacity is different, but pressure is same. Pressure is? Pressure inside the CO2 cylinder is 56 bar. Here weight of CO2 is 45 kg. In what form? Liquid. Pilot cylinder, some places is 9 kg, some places is 11 kg, depending upon the system. But 9 kg is again in a liquid form. One cylinder is sufficient both to activate the main valve as well as the bank. But some ships what they have done, one cylinder is used for opening only the main valve, the other one will use the for the valves. Because all these valves on the cylinder head, they are all pressure activated valves.
Pressure?
The CO2 pilot cylinder here will go to open a system for admitting the pneumatic air pressure. Thereby the main valve opens, then the CO2 starts coming. Everything will have a non-return valve. Each cylinder will have a non-return valve. In this cylinder head assembly, on the side you have got a bursting disc. There was somebody's question was there, somebody was asking, in case there is a fire in CO2 room, what will happen? How do you fight this now? No, only the relief valve will release the thing, send that bottle etc. to atmosphere, but how to fight this fire? How to fight this fire? That bursting disc will bust out. Bursting disc will, when the temperature rises due to the fire or a flame, cylinder pressure will rise. Cylinder pressure will rise. The bursting disc on the cylinder head valve assembly, the main valve will not be activated. The cylinder head, the safety device bursting disc will burst out and then CO2 will come back to CO2 room itself. Thereby the fire or flame can be put off. General idea, but in my knowledge, as Janaka I am telling you, very very impossible for having a fire in the CO2. Because all these electrical systems, electrical wiring and bulbs, lighting etc. should be flame proof. Flame? And all these wirings are taken with the help of a conduit which are well insulated. But by chance, due to some reason, what they say, maybe some static discharge etc., that the fire takes place or flame takes place, the cylinder head bursting disc is there that can bust out. The CO2 will come into the CO2 room itself. That CO2 will put out the flame of fire. There is no separate arrangement here. But safeties, they got the exhaust fan, and then the safety CO2 manifold. You have got a relief valve. To my knowledge, as far as our Indian system is concerned, our administration requirement, this relief valve is set for 180 bar. It goes to the deck, open deck in the aft side, with a gooseneck, and it is released to the deck only. This will take place only when all these things are not opening and manifold pressure is going on increasing. Manifold pressure is going on increasing. Second thing, by chance the main valve is getting blocked or stuck up. Pressure is building up in the manifold. That does not create any exigencies in the CO2 room, so the relief valve will be there. Some countries, again I have not seen those ships, but they have got a bursting disc even in the main manifold. This is only a hearsay. And whatever I am getting in websites etc., they say that there is a bursting disc set for the 180 bar. But Indian administration and UK administration, they insist on this relief valve which is to be let on to the deck. Always remember there is a boost neck. And when CO2 is going to get released and they expand, it will form a dry ice. There will be a ice blockage or something. So for that we put a double plate to withstand that thermal stress. Majority of the velocity is high, there will be no dry ice. It is going to be very slow. That's why when CO2 is released, you feel the cylinder at the bottom, it will become little cooler. When it's getting empty. So this particular thing and all these things should be mounted on a preferably wooden platform to prevent the cylinder getting dusted at the bottom. We don't keep any other flammable material inside the CO2. That one precaution you are supposed to take.
Sir, so bursting disc and relief valve both set for 180 bar, sir?
180 bar. Bursting disc on the manifold. It is a safety for the manifold. There is another small bursting disc that is in the cylinder head valve itself, that is for the cylinder protection. Cylinder by chance some pressure builds up in a particular cylinder due to some reason, that will protect the cylinder from bursting off. The material is pass off once. Which is the bursting disc for the cylinder head valve is pass off valve. Even for the main manifold, pass off valve. So these are the data given. Video is on. These are the data given. Please refer to FSS code also for further clarification. Pressure of CO2 at 25 degrees centigrade will be around 56 and 30 will be of corresponding will be more. Sorry. 56 bar at 20 degrees Celsius. When it goes 25, pressure may be 64 bar and 30 degrees means 31 bar. So it's important to keep the temperature of the CO2 bottles low for limiting the pressure inside the bottle. Pressure inside the bottle. So, the temperature from unable to maintain below the critical temperature, CO2 will give us. There may be a loss, there may be
loss.
So, we are supposed to weigh the CO2 bottles at regular intervals as per your PMS. Some places they say once in a year, mandatory requirement you are supposed to weigh the CO2 bottles to see the level. In case the CO2 level is below that specified level, we are supposed to refill. So we have to take all precautions in disconnecting that particular cylinder from the bank and then send it ashore for refilling. Because you don't have facility for filling up in the ship. It has to be sent ashore. So
volume
that
in the bottle.
Huh?
Volume in the bottle will be calculated only by weight or
here we are looking at the weight, specific weight of CO2 is 0.56. So you know what is volume. Specific weight of the CO2 is 0.56. Okay. Normally we represent by weight. So CO2 release cabinet, as you saw in that two pilot cylinder individual cabinet. I can operate this. When I open this door, alarm sounds. Alarm? So the people are supposed to vacate the engine room immediately. Don't bother about that something or tightening up or anything, just leave and then come out, report to muster station, and then that accordingly this will be deserted. So one cylinder is used for opening the main valve first. Same thing, I got two valves here, so accordingly I can control, each cylinder I can control, and the other one with the time delay in it can open the bank. 60 to 90 seconds, some ship they have got 90 units, some ship they have got only 30 seconds. The reason they are giving for the time delay is, one is that it is because the pressure activated, it takes some time for the main valve to open and then this is to be released. Another thing is, you have to give some time for the people to evacuate. According to FSS code, they say that the release of the main cylinder should not be less than 20 seconds. It should be only after 20 seconds. Safety seal. As per FSS code, it clearly mentioned the section code, etc. I have mentioned.
So I cannot understand. What is the 20 second?
Hmm? The FSS code says, I'll just show you
the minimum 20 seconds.
Yeah.
20 seconds.
No, no, no. 30 seconds. What's your time?
Minimum recurrent 20 seconds.
So when I go back to the slides, regulation for the international code for fire safety system, FSS code 2.1.3.2 says the pre-discharge alarm can be automatically activated when I open the release door. There should be a limit switch. When I open it up, it activates an alarm. The alarms will operate for the length of the time needed to evacuate the space, but in no case less than 20 seconds before the meeting is placed. So the minimum time delay required is 20 seconds as per FSS code, but according to our safety requirement, we can keep it 60 seconds, but not exceeding 90 seconds, not exceeding. Some ship they got 30 seconds, some ship they got 30 seconds. So see, if CMOD is released from the main bottles to the common address before opening the master valve, there may be difficulty in opening the master valve under the pressure. Each cylinder is going to give out a pressure of 56 bar. Again, another some important information I want to give you here is, now individual cylinder has got 56 bar pressure. When it expands coming to the manifold, the pressure may be 155 bar here. At 155 bar, it enters the machinery space. Through the nozzle, it expands. So the liquid becomes vapor very fast. Sudden expansion to the low pressure, high pressure to low pressure. So it is 155 bar pressure here. Normally, that relieving system, we keep it around 135%. So it is set for 180 bar or 190 bar. So if I want to maintain the pressure in the liquid level, the temperature is another very important criteria. The critical temperature is very important. And the CO2 normally protected from external mixing by means of a bulkhead arrangement called class B bulkhead. Class B bulkhead means it has got the insulation in such a way that the temperature withstandability is more than 220 degrees centigrade.
The reason for the relief valve, I think, is the manifold valve is not open. Only that one or any other reason?
Relief valve, yeah, by chance the manifold valve is getting blocked, or the main valve is getting blocked, or some nozzle is getting blocked, the manifold is getting pressurized. The manifold is getting pressurized. Existing pressure 150 bar. If it goes 180 bar, I have to protect. So the relief valve is there. Indicating there is some blockage from there, so the pressure is building up here. Pressure is, because all the cylinders are open within 2 minutes, huh? That minimum 85% has to discharge
out of
sitting room. So that
how to find that, sir? It will release in 2 minutes, 80%
it will release.
See, if you have the CO2 room, that bottle is not here, they hear the big loud noise one. Second thing, you can feel the cylinders, how many cylinders are getting emptied. So, see, entire thing is going so fast. You don't exactly can clock it for 2 minutes because you are not going to dry out that way. But if you have given the CO2 room, you can just feel the cylinder which are all becoming cold. Sometimes you find the bottom slightly becoming icy. So you have to bank of cylinders having for totally 200. At least in your eye view, you are able to see 160 and some cylinders are becoming empty. You are ensured. But at the time of fire or at the time of emergency, we are just releasing, we are into the everything is released. Everything is released. Completely everything, the ventilation is shut off, the two closing walls have activated to shut off your fuel system, etc. You have to say 85% just to prevent that spread of the flame. You can have only physical checkup. We can't have any automatic measurement or anything like that, it has been discharged.
Oh, sir, if it does that answer, they are asking that we will be having front. 2 minutes, cylinders will be 135 or something number. How can you feel that all the thing is released or not by feeling with your hand?
Very difficult. I'm not saying it's not a easy joke, but the big load, the noise which is coming for releasing the CO2, you find bulk. You just imagine 135 cylinders are releasing. What will be the noise level and what will be the noise level of these one or two cylinders escaping, right? One idea. Second thing, yeah, as fast as possible, whatever I can do, I can just check up. I can have a visual inspection. At the bottom, it will be sort of icy formation will be there, or some water droplets like a moisture formation will be there, indicating temperature is going up. Only by that I can make out. Otherwise, there is no other quantum of measurement or anything. I can't use any ultrasonic or anything to measure the level of mucus window that has got emptied or not.